What is up, you guys? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. For those of you who are new, my name is Jaclyn, and welcome to my channel. Today's video is going to be a little bit different. I'm going to go ahead and just sit down and chit chat with you guys about the curly hair community, how it was when I was growing up, and then how it is now. And meanwhile, we're going to be chit chatting about the curly hair community. I am going to be trying out the Curl Mix hair products. I want to give them a huge shout out for sponsoring this video. Thank you so much. I'm going to be telling you guys my honest opinions on these products. So if you guys are excited and want to see what I have to say, then just keep on watching. So the first step to this wash and go, of course, you guys, is this shampoo. Now the shampoo is a clarifying shampoo that contains aloe vera. It does help remove any buildup that you have. And you guys, I did have some buildup. The last time I clarified my hair was a little bit over a month. So I definitely was in need of a clarifying shampoo. So of course, make sure your hair is soaking wet before applying shampoo. You're gonna massage the shampoo onto your scalp, massaging it very gently, but also making sure that you're removing all that extra buildup. This product felt amazing on my hair. I did feel like it did a good job of removing the buildup, but I also felt like it was still moisturizing. So it did not feel like it was stripping my oils away, but it did do a good job of removing any excess buildup that I had from all the products from before, but really liked it for a clarifying shampoo. Of course, the next step is, you guys, the conditioner. And the conditioner is a hydrating one that has ultra slip and it contains grapeseed. This conditioner definitely had some slip to it. I really felt that it was very easy to detangle with just using my fingers. Definitely had a lot of slip, and that is definitely a plus for conditioners. So the next product to use after conditioner is your moisturizers. And this moisturizer contains organic castor oil. So how it tells you to apply it is, of course, on soaking wet hair. So in the directions, it does tell you how many pumps you need depending on your hair density and or texture. So for me, I have wavy to curly hair. So for me, it does recommend to add one pump per section. This product is really not that thick. It's pretty light. I like how the consistency feels. It does feel like it's gonna be a moisturizing product. I'm gonna apply it to pumps. My hair definitely drank this product up right away. This feels really, really moisturizing. I definitely love how this feels in my hair. Very smooth and very slick. Can you guys believe that we're already in September? School has started. Everybody's going back to school. Soon they're going to be having picture day. Talking about picture day, I want to talk to you guys about how I used to style my hair back in the day. I was born in the 90s, you guys. So back in the day, curly hair wasn't really hot like it is now. Like, I felt that curly hair was ugly. I felt like it was too much to manage. Like, I didn't even know how to manage my curly hair. I didn't really embrace my curls. You know, my mom had straight hair and all my other siblings had straight hair, so I was the only one with curly hair, and I really didn't know how to take care of it. I feel like there wasn't enough like publicity, or there wasn't enough tutorials, or enough emphasis on curly hair. Social media back in the day, which was just really the TV, really showed women with straight hair being beautiful, and not that many women with curly hair would pop up on, you know, my television, or like having commercials embracing curly hair with curly hair products. So back then, I just felt like straight hair was it. If you didn't have straight hair, you better have a blow dryer and a brush to straighten your hair, because those two were my best friends when it came to, you know, picture day for school or any formal event. And you guys, let me just tell you that I was in middle school when I started blow drying my hair. I would try to blow dry my hair, you guys, and no lie, I would look like a freaking poof ball. And you know, I thought it was cute because it was straight. I didn't have curly hair. My hair was semi-straight, so I thought it was cute. My hair just looks so poofy. But you know, nowadays, I am just so happy that people are embracing their curly hair, and I'm glad that I am here embracing my curls and giving you guys my tips and tricks and showing you guys what products work for my type of hair. If you guys have my type of hair, then it may work for you. But I'm just glad that, you know, we're in this community now where there's so many people with curly hair that are embracing their curls and are showing their tips and tricks and are showing their knowledge of how products work for their type of hair. I am also glad that there's just so many different products out there that you can try to see what works for you. And that's why I am glad that Curl Mix came out with all these different kits that you can try. They really make it so simple for you. Their kit includes 4 different steps, from washing all the way to the last step, which is styling your hair. So the last step is gel, and that is the Pure Flaxseed Gel with organic castor oil. And it's a very watery gel. I'm intrigued to see how this is gonna turn out. Ooh, a lot of slips. So when you put it in your hair, it does feel a little bit more flaxy than it does when you just pump it into your hand. So I'm just gonna use a demon brush to really emphasize certain areas that lack curls. I really want to scrunch in the product to make sure that my curls are nice and defined. Alright guys, so I went ahead and added the products. My hair is starting to get dry a little bit, so I'm gonna go ahead and let it air dry for, 30 minutes, then finish off diffusing, and then I'll be back to show you guys the final results. I'll see you guys in a few. Alright, so here you go guys. This is how my hair looks. I do have a little bit of definition with the products. My hair does look very moisturized. I definitely love the moisture that it's giving me. It looks really nice and shiny and healthy. It just doesn't have as much definition as my hair would have with other products, but it's okay because I'm here for the volume. And my hair feels really soft. So let's just talk a little bit about the products. The cream felt really hydrating. It definitely felt really great in my hair. My hair soaked it up right away. And then the gel, it was weird because the gel felt really watery, but when I applied it to my hair, it started feeling a little bit more sticky, like the flaxseed. I was really shocked by the gel because it definitely caught me off guard with how it felt on my palm compared to how it actually felt when it was in my hair. It did leave a cast, so if you like having a cast, then it did have quite of a little hold to it. But once I diffused it and added an oil to make sure that it locks in all that moisture, the cast kind of went away. So my hair does feel really nice and bouncy and soft. It feels really light. So my hair does not feel heavy at all. These products did not weigh down my hair at all. So I also am giving it a plus because of that. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys did, make sure to give it a big thumbs up. Also, you guys, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you have yet to subscribe, what are you doing? Hit the subscribe button down below, or my little face icon will pop up right there. And most importantly, don't forget to turn on the post notification bell. That way you guys won't miss out on any more of my videos. I will see you guys next time. Bye, loves. Mwah.